Hey, how you doing, everybody? This is John, another video of Traveling with John. Today we're in Live Oak, Texas, and we are checking out the San Antonio Model Railroad Train Association. According to their website and their Google page, they have a huge model train layout. As a young kid, I was always interested in model trains, but never had one. So this would be a great opportunity to check it out and share my visit with you. So let's go inside and see what they have.
Well, that is awesome.
We're supposed to have the stockyards at some point, but
that's the Texas Pacific Depot up there.
We're gradually working. Normally we'll do scenery from the
still there.
To the
it's condominium ground, now.
That wasn't done.
But we were going to do that in the freight house. But it took up the entire side right here, and it looked like a coffin.
So you said this whole area represents the
Fort Worth
stockyards. Wow.
It's 33 inches.
This is awesome.
There's our biggest stockyards down here.
For a 4x8 layout, you need 18 to 22.
Of course, this is up near Saginaw, outside of Fort Worth.
Because if you got a 4x8, you can always run a spur over and have a little shelf.
Oh my god. This
is it's intimidating as
here.
Especially if you're trying to figure out
your whistles and bells.
You're looking at the map and you're looking at the industry and you're going.
This train's a little long for operations. Usually we try to keep them under 12 because it's a nightmare to switch all those cars in and out, you know. So you might have to pick up this one and there might be two in front of it. So you got to pull those two out, stick them on here, pull that one out, and then put these two back, you know, where they are. A lot of times on your orders for the train, there's three doors, so they'll say door one, two, or three.
Mm-hmm.
You need to pick up this one at door three, so you know where to find it.
And so when Chris relocates, it'll be up there. That's not just carries on from there.
This is a Texas thing, and so far, and it's in Georgia too, chain gang. Here's the work area. You can see, and there's like the fun run. If you come for fun run, there's engines and cars back there that you can pick up and run around the layout, so you don't have to have your own stuff.
Is he a
hammer
you would have to have Larry.
He's running one of my trains.
You can.
Now is where you're going into dark territory, the junction. So it'll miss here from here, and come out. And
this is
I have one of these.
Yeah.
town and you tell them that your OS is coming in or going out, you tell them where you are. Slide your little magnet.
Train some.
Yep. Coming out, and then you'll be on the lowest line, and that'll take you back to Rimrock.
I
So after watching the trains for a while, when I came inside, they gave me the guided tour of this one piece, this one huge layout. So for those of you that like model trains, it's definitely worth visiting. There's no admission to the place. They do ask, you know, for donations when you come here. So it's definitely worth the visit. You only have a couple trains running so far, so but it's definitely worth, you know, just sitting and watching it.
Oh, it's right there.
So they definitely have a really nice setup.
This is, we have a couple of folks here that is did really great work, but here's the junk cars, and there she is over the fence. You know? There's a lot of little things, you know. A lot of little things.
I saw that before we go home.
Yeah. And you know New Braunfels is on the map because they got a Dairy Queen. And they got a lot of moving.
The fact that you put a little Ford in there was weird.
It didn't come up at the board meeting. This was brought up under new business at the business meeting that the membership discussed. And a motion was made, a vote was taken, and it carried by, you know, it's a simple vote void based on...
If it's regular... It's regular business.
You know, the motion is being brought to the floor, that this is being brought to the floor, it's important. And so it is a piece of business that will drive this motion and membership present. So if there was four. Well, it's not so much policy change, it's that's what they adopted as a going forward, new members coming in. They will purchase a free insurance. And it doesn't discount any of the other things that other people have used to purchase. You know, like I said, I had that set. I'm still going to be whatever knows. You know, I went around down there at Sam and I went around, you know, just to look at the age of life and throw a polo on. But the reason that they wanted to be in the doctrine of that. A bunch of us down in black with the white logo. It's a nice look to it. They want uniformity, so wanting to go with the color of the dark blue or the black. And the dark blue may have more of a color support than black again. So that's where it is. But it's normal in the course of business. You know, if you've got a forum, the club itself can do this, you've got a good routine. Things that happen at the board meeting, you know, there's certain things that the board will discuss that could be going to the membership, it's a new subject, stuff like that. But anytime you have a forum, business gets
can be brought to the floor, and then you've got the quorum.
Second on the name?
The vote can be taken.
Oh.
Well, on a vote like this, there are no proxies. It's a simple vote, a voice vote. It has nothing to do with the
Is this your thing?
Yeah.
So there we go. The San Antonio Model Train Association. So definitely it's an impressive layout. Great job. Like I said before, when you come here, there's no admission. It's just strictly they take donations. So if you just donate a couple of dollars and help them keep them going, maintain the model, you know. And also, I'll put a, you know, check the description link. I'll be putting more information about this association and their website address. Alright, and thank you very much for checking out this video. I hope you like it. Subscribe, comment, and like, and I'll see you next time. Bye.